We are now going through a very devastating situation in all over India. The COVID second wave is now more serious, more rigorous, and it has really taken a heavy toll on many of us. We never expected this kind of situation. We thought that COVID one is over, but we are really now going through a very, very serious crisis, and we have to be very, very careful, and also we have to abide by the what is the government instructions are. I am really going to share five things for us to follow up during this situation. My first point is, we are all familiar with the Swamaha. So now I am going to talk about Swamaha Plus. So what is this Swamaha Plus? This Swamaha Plus is, we are not only really doing a Swamaha, social distance and mask wearing and hand sanitizing, but what is more important along with that, so we need to go for counseling of members to come out of the fear, and that is very, very important. Not only that, counseling, and they also have to be really do a kind of process of vaccination drive. All of us have to really reach out to 100% vaccination, and all of us should really move into a kind of testing drive of 100%. So this, what I call it as a CWAT, what is counseling and vaccination and testing drive. Swamaha Plus should be really counseling and vaccination drive, and also testing drive is very, very important, along with the health support for immunity building we should do. I think this Swamaha Plus is going to be our mantra for the second wave. The second very important things now, we need to really look for local resource mobilization to tide over the cash flow and the cash crisis. So what we should do? One is tap all the government entitlement. Now every state government announcing certain processes for us. So let us tap the, like what we did for last COVID one wave, to tap the government entitlement, either 2,000 or 4,000 rupees given by government, for example in Tamil Nadu or in any location like Madurai Arman. We have 17,000 families in Madurai we are really working with. If it's a 2,000 May itself, they should take 34 lakhs so that they can tide over the local cash crunch. Second one is, we should also promote local philanthropies. Now we said that for three areas we should really promote local philanthropies. Is one is a kind of somebody who is in a home quarantine, we can give a medical kit for them, and those who are in a and also with medicines and that kind of kit, which we have now developed, and Sugam is going to really help you on that. And we will also really look at the people who are suspect cases. They need to really go through immunity boosters, and also like Siddha medicines and homeopathy medicine like arsenic album. So we need to really also not only go for these, with the local philanthropies. We work with banks and insurance companies. Let us really reach out to the significant philanthropic people to really tap those resources for us. Thirdly, what I would really like to say is, the livelihood are going to be fully affected and also partially affected. How are we going to really handle that? Now this time, we have a good experience for COVID-1. So let us really work on the alternate livelihood, local alternate livelihood. Autowala, he doesn't have a work. So let him really sell vegetables to the homes of the streets and other things. So let him get an alternative local as a secondary livelihood. That is going to be very important for us to tide over the livelihoods affected areas. Secondly, these livelihood groups we need to really form, and that is very, very important. The other point which is more important is, fourth one, we should go for organizing the consumer products at the doorstep. We have done that last time. So every federation can create a kind of revolving fund to really support the kind of consumer goods for our members to tide over this kind of situation. So what shall we do? So we have to really go for very, very each person's what essentials, we should really buy and supply to the each family. This is what we call it as a prosumer concept or a consumer cooperative. It should not be stop at COVID situation, and it should continue beyond that. And the last point which I really would like you to really go for, the Jeevitham groups. Jeevitham groups is nothing but livelihood renovation groups, and also local heritage foods and medicine should be really taken with us. I think these are the initial few thoughts, and I will come back again within another week on how to really reduce the or stop the death of our members. So far our members death is counting around 80 people. So, which is really very much saddening and also devastating us. So, let us stop the death of a member's death, so that we can have a rigorous community call centers follow up, and also virtual wellness center to talk to the doctors with the e-Sanjeevani medicines. So, let us really work towards this and keep in touch in very rigorously with the last mile presence of ours with all our members. Let us really face this situation and come out of it.